Hello everybody and welcome to the start of our second career mode here on FIFA 19 with Atletico Madrid. This is our, I suppose, big boy career mode. I don't know how else to say it. As you can see, here we are, Atletico Madrid. You can read all that shite if you want to. Mattresses. Okay, cool. And yeah, basically, trying to win the Liga, trying to win Champions League, all that good stuff. Trying to throne at Real Madrid in terms of European football. But yeah, we're here with Atletico Madrid. I don't know why I picked Atletico Madrid, I'll be honest. I just thought it's a bit different from, you know, others. I imagined a few people would do Tottenham. I imagined that, obviously, Arsenal, Chelsea, all that. Plus, I've done a lot in England in terms of career mode, so I thought we'd go to Spain and we'd do Atletico Madrid. We'd be this guy, so it's just go to win. And the generic faces that they've not changed yet again. That's always nice. So other name. But yeah, if you haven't seen it already, after this now, obviously, or come back if you want to, you could link and come back. I have started my Fulham career mode. We're two episodes into that, so be sure to check that out. If you're new around here and you do enjoy this video or any FIFA 19 videos, whatever, be sure to stick around and subscribe. Anyway, what are we doing? Champions League is enabled. What are the groups looking like? Are they realistic? I can't remember who's in Atletico's group. We're just going to go with it. Are we going to go with it? I think these groups are realistic, aren't they? These are the actual groups. So yeah, we'll go with that anyway. I think we've got Dortmund our group there, and they've got Signal Iduna Park back, so that should be decent. So basically, as I said, our aim for this career mode is pretty simple. It's try and win the Liga, try and get as far in the Champions League as possible, win it at some point. And it's literally as simple as that. In terms of realism, I'm not going to be too careful with that sort of thing, and as you can see, my four slots are already taken up. We'll take the Malaga one out because I don't want to do that one anymore. It's ridiculous that we only get four slots. How the fuck that happened, I don't know, but hopefully they'll sort that. And we're get started here, obviously, pre-season tournament, all that good shit. I think we'll do the 11 million one. The teams in that aren't too, you know, difficult. So let's look at the team. Obviously, we played as these lot in the demo. I don't know how much it's changed, but I'm certainly going to change the tactics slightly. That's scout. I don't really want to look at that yet. Expectations. Obviously, a majority of them critical. Finance, they don't care too much about. Youth development, could look at doing that. And 176 million from shirt sales. That's relatively easy on this game, isn't it? Let's be fair. And get 316 million through media earnings within three seasons. If we do as well as we should, that should be relatively easy as well. It was to reach the Champions League final, which they have done in recent years. Obviously, they won the Europa League, didn't they? So European football is something that they're clearly quite apt at. And that's something I haven't considered, actually. We've got the Super Cup game as well, haven't we? And in terms of the league, they want us to win the league title and reach the final of the Copa de España. In terms of team, oh, I really like the fact they've got Martins, that's good. I don't know what I want to do with them. Should I keep it 4-4-2? I mean, it's a bit unconventional, that sort of formation, isn't it? But it's certainly in Spain, anyway. Kalinic would keep off the bench, we'll put, what's his name, Vitolo on it. But I think actually this is alright, this team. Although, I don't really like the idea of Koke being on the left, because he's just a bit too slow for me. So I think we'll put Koke back in the midfield. He's also going to be on the left, apparently. And we'll start Martins. I think that's probably the best bet for that. What else do... Who do we keep on the bench now? I'm going to put Rodri on the bench. Correa there. And Kalinic, you're back on the bench now. Lucky guy. So yeah, I think we're going to go with this. In terms of tactics, I do want to balance. Oh, it's balanced, okay. Constant pressure. I want to possession. Let's get people in the box. Yeah, let's do that. Yeah, I think that's good. I think that's good. I keep erming. I'm trying not to erm so much, but I just love erming. I think that's good for now. I think areas we need to get. As much as there's not an abundance in the world of football in terms of world-class fullbacks, I would quite like to have different fullbacks. I think Filippo Luis is okay for now, but at 32, he will get worse. He's 6 foot though, so he could potentially be a backup for right back. Juan Fran, he's 33. He's quite quick still though, to be fair to him, so we might actually give them the benefit of the doubt. But I'd like some quick fullbacks. We've actually got Hernandez on the bench here, who's all right actually. We could potentially just go with him. So maybe you only need a right back. Although we've got him here, so he's not very good. I would like to have another world-class striker, just because why not? And possibly two actual other wingers, because as much as Lamar and Vermed again, Lamar and Mertens are decent, quite young wingers. I would quite like to have a couple more that are slightly better and have them as sort of longer term players. As for the rest of the team's actually set, I think we don't even really need backup, but I mean, like I say, this isn't going to be a very realistic career mode in terms of the players I'm going to try and bring in. So I think I'm going to buy players anyway. But what are we doing now? What should we do now? Let's transfer list some people, shall we? Reyes on loan? Is he on loan at Aston Villa? Oh, okay. I didn't know that. Who are we going to... Okay, you can go, because I don't know why you're really here, to be honest. Same with... Oh, can't do anything about him. Cool. I wish... Why can't we loan these players out still? What the fuck is going on there? You know his name. Why is he being loaned out? That's interesting. I wouldn't mind him. But we'll keep him on loan, it's fine. We can't do anything with Arias because he's only just been brought in. You're not good enough, you can go. You're not good enough, you can go. You're not good enough, you can go. Lots of youngsters here that aren't good enough, and another one that we can't do anything with. There's lots of... There's a fair few youngsters that just aren't worth the time. Oh, why are these people... Why have they signed this bloke? Why have they signed him? What is the point in that? Rodriguez can go. You're alright, actually. We'll keep you about. You're bold. Interesting. How old is he? 17. Okay. You're alright as well. You look like you could potentially grow a little bit. I can't sell Kalinic. I don't really want him about, which is annoying. Why are you set at the club since 2018 as well? What is with these players? We've got someone called Obama who we're going to just keep because they're called Obama. I find that quite amusing. So that's sales done. And then finally, before we skip forward a little bit, because obviously I don't want to spend the whole bloody transfer window on here. In terms of scouts, they've got Spain, Germany, England, France. I think the only other, the sensible place to go after that would be Italy. Where's Italy? There's Italy. And then... I always struggle with the last country. As he's Dutch, there's some good youngsters in the Dutch league, obviously. I think we'll send him to the Netherlands. There we go. In terms of instructions, let's just get rid of all of these because they're probably shit. While we're talking about the promising one, we'll do the promising. Just any position, any promising talent I've had. We'll go full back and we'll go world class, see if we can get anything. Pacey. Winger, world class again. Pacey, as we do. Striker, world class. Prolific this time. And... No, we'll just leave that one. And as I said on my... I think I said this on my film one anyway. If I didn't, I know I'm making myself look stupid. But I always like to do one, any position, obviously we're put world class, just so we get good players. Just with, and I put their contract to 0 to 1 years. Not all the players that go in there have their contracts up at the end of the season, for whatever reason. But quite a few of them do, and it's just good to have a place where all the potential players we can sign on the free go. We've only got one player at the moment, and that's Rodrigo. He's actually all right. It'd be a decent little backup. He's quick and he's 6 foot. That's not too bad. Anyway, that's pretty much wraps up all that, all the first little things. I'll let you know when stuff happens, basically, stuff worth talking about. So our first bit of sort of major transfer news. Liverpool have come in and offered a bid for Lucas Hernandez, who is someone that I don't particularly want to let go. But he's also not starting. It's a weird one. If I can get like 50 odd million for him, I think I'd be more than happy to see him go, but they've only offered 28.6, so I don't think they're going to go up that much, which doesn't bother me. I get to keep him, so that's in being very, I mean, that's nearly half of what I'm asking for, so I'm not particularly, I mean, they put it up a little bit. Do I care about losing this guy? He's quite good. He is a good player to have. But he's not going to play too much, and like I said, this isn't going to be a too long time. But anyway, they've said no, as it is. So that's all good. We keep him. I'm sure he'll be moaning in about a month's time because I'm not going to start him. As just for just to let you know, the first game will be the Europa Super Cup, so that will be the first game we do. Whether we do it on this episode or not, it depends on what happens. This might just be like an intro episode. We then got Valencia and Rayo Vallecano. Obviously, with all these grounds in the game now, it makes going playing these teams a lot better, really, in the Liga. So I look forward to playing quite a few league games as well as Champions League, which I haven't actually played a European game yet on the actual game. Another transfer and another one from Liverpool yet again. They're trying their luck here, aren't they? They've offered 17.5 million for Felipe Luis. Now I need a bit more than that. I know he's old, and I am looking at a left back anyway. But I need a little bit more than that. If we can get 25 million for 32-year-old, I won't be too disheartened. And he's gone again. We're gonna fall out, mate. I mean, they're trying to get like the best deals possible for my players. It's not happening, Jurgen, mate. It's not happening. Yet again, Felipe Luis is getting a bid for him. Man United this time, so the other side. We're not going to treat them any differently. We're going to ask for 25 million. If they don't want to pay 25 million, they don't have to pay 25 million. It's simple as that. Simple as that. It's a bit of a, if he goes, he goes. If he stays for me, because I've got a left back on my shortlist that I will just go and, okay, I will just go and sign. Ooh, Savage now. Who's not in. Again, isn't in our starting 11. It's Arsenal and they're going to be a bit stingy because it's Arsenal. But let's see what we can do with them. Okay. They put it up though. That's the thing that I'm going to look at as a positive. They put up further. They put up further. I think they might budge for the extra 1.2 million here. Oh, there we go. I knew it. I had a feeling. We've just got 40 million for an 83 overall backup, say, at centre back. I think that's pretty decent. I think that's pretty decent indeed. And like London buses, they just keep coming now. Another bid for this time, a big player. A player I'd rather, I mean, but this is quite entertaining. Let's see if we can get 100 million for this, for Sal. Now this is a player that would need serious replacing, but at the same time, it'd be quite nice to get 100 million for a player. Come on, Pep. I know all the money you're sat on. Let's remove that release clause. Let's not get cheeky here. Did the release clauses even actually come into effect? I've never noticed it. 100 million, come on, lad. Come on. Oh, he's gone up quite a lot there. Just an extra 11 million, Pep. That's like pennies for you lot. Come on. You know you want to. Ah, he's got no balls. Man United deciding they're not done with just one player from us, they also want a party. So let's see what we can get here. Again, another player that isn't even on our bench. So in theory, we shouldn't be too concerned about losing him, but at the same time, I'm gonna go in at 45 million. That'll be all right for me. I'll take 45. They put up to 40. They're gonna go for 45, aren't they? Could have put up more. Damn it. Never mind. The fact we're getting, I mean, like I say, party, whatever you want to call him, doesn't even get onto our bench. Oh, they're being pricks now, aren't they? And we could potentially be getting rid of him. You know what? I'll meet you halfway-ish. We'll go 42 and a half. There we go, Jose. See? He looks so nice and neat there, doesn't he? Compared to real life, where he's an absolute train wreck. It's interesting, isn't it? They should make it so when they're not doing very well, clubs, that the managers physically look like they are have been pulled through a bush. I think that should be a feature. Put that on the list for FIFA 20. I know they're busy for FIFA 20, but FIFA 21 then. So we're only a few days away from the Real Madrid game. This is my shortlist. I feel like before we get into that game against the smaller club in the city, we've got to actually think about buying our own players now. And I've got a few here. And as you can see, there's two left backs at this moment in time. We've got Hernandez there. Robertson, I did actually really want Robertson, but 17.5 million, and he's too important. I mean, if I went and offered them 60 million, they would take it. It's not that important to them. So we also have Alexandro. But left back, I don't know if we're going to go in yet. Alexandro will be quite expensive for a left back, won't he? So we'll think about that. We've got a fair amount of youngsters on it. And in terms of actual players we're going to go for, now you're probably looking at some of them and thinking, they'd be decent. The reason why I've got Martial and Rashford on here is, as much as I said I wasn't going to be realistic, these would actually be quite realistic buys in my opinion, because I think Martial in particular is probably incredibly infuriated at Manchester United, and Rashford can't be too far behind. So I am considering going for the two of them. However, I was kind of like, I want Insigne. Oh, bloody names. Insigne as well. But again, he's going to cost an absolute fucking bombshell amount of money. And I can't... I mean, how much money do we have? That's a good question. How much money? We have 198 million. Why am I really worrying about cash? But I do think that... See, a part of me really, really wants to have both Martial and Rashford. Martial will cost 28.8 million. He would cost... We could get him for 23. I'm going to go for both of them. I'm going to try and get a good deal for both of them as well, because I feel like it's possible. So if we... 25 million for Martial. They want 38. Thank you. 28 million? Because that's where the recommendation starts. 31, they have put it down a little bit. Right, 29.5. Right, okay, that's alright. Right, what are we going to get for what's this, chops? What are we going to go for Rashford? I'm feeling we go for his value of 23. We try that. Not really sure where both of these would fit in. It's just having them. Is there a player we could swap? Isn't that interesting? That's an interesting thought, isn't it? Will they take Vitolo, for example? They're a striker. Oh, okay. Offer of a striker. Who do we have up for? Kalinic. Fullbacks. We don't really have an abundance of good fullbacks. We could give him Marius. Who's worth more money? 10.5. No, it takes Santiago. Oh, I don't want him. Oh. See, I was going to try and offer them that much anyway, so it's not really fun to plan here. 15 and Arias. 22. I know what fucking sell on clause are. This is an absolute ball lake at the moment. Not going to lie, Jose. That 80 million. That. Okay, you're getting a little bit. I mean, I can't be doing that. 19, that totals 30 overall. Come on. You're breaking my balls here. Oh, you've gone and fucking. Has he put it up, if anything? I swear he's put it up. What about 20? 20 and I've even thrown a fucking sell on clause. I'll give you 10% if I ever sell him. That's a better one. There we go. See, why couldn't we just agree before, eh? Right. Where next? Where next? That is a good question. We could sign Icardi. We could sign Cavani. I've got Jamie Rashford. Jesus, I'm mixing my names up. Got Jamie Vardy on here as well, just for. You never know, you might need a. Never know when you need a Jamie Vardy having a party. So. That's. Left wing is more than settled now. I don't think we need any more. Obviously, the big elephant in the room is left back. And. Could honestly do with another centre back as well. Oh, what, we only live. Yeah, let's fuck it. We're going to try and get this guy for 35 million. That's going to be our starting point anyway. I'm pretty sure they will reject that. And they might even do the good old storm off and have a bit of a huff. So let's see if they do that. 35 million? 47. Okay, they haven't. At least they haven't gone all pissy. That's something. How about 37? Oh. Okay, didn't expect that to go through. I think we managed to get an absolute bargain there. Now it's all about bloody wages, isn't it? Because they're all going to want basically a Bugatti, a yacht, probably the Sun. They'd probably want to own the Sun. I mean the actual Star, not the fucking newspaper. Important. Will you accept that? Yeah, you will. Good lad. You know what, I'll go one better and I'll give you 5 years, Anthony. How about that? Yep, you like that, don't you? Release, how much did I buy him for? Know what, we're ballsy, we'll keep it. He put his wage well down as well, so agreeing to that sort of thing is actually quite useful. Let's see if we can get a million shaved off the appearance. Oh, we have, good, there we go. Decent. Right, Marcus, getting through them. We get to lose a right back that we really didn't want as well, so it's all swings and roundabouts. Is that the right expression? Do you think we can get away with rotation? We can, good. 5 years, that's, I was going to offer you that anyway. Now, see, we're already basically for at home. You see, I've got more of an issue with Rashford because I feel like he'll be worth that in a few years. You know what, we gave Anthony, we're basically like friends, so I'm going to use his first name. I gave him a release clause, so we're going to try. Okay, there you go. See, it hasn't really made an impact. So maybe I should have denied the release clause, but we live and learn. Anyway, finally, Alexandro, and these are going to be our three main buys, I think, before the Super Cup. We might go in for some youngsters at some point as well, but I won't bore you with that on camera because they're not really that important to right now. We got him on crucial. Five. Oh, he's 27. I didn't really want to do that. See, I still think I'm playing FIFA 14 because he would have been, what, 24, 3? I've mugged myself off there. Based on the last people's wages, I'm going to give him 100k because he seems to put that down. We're going to go for a minute. Oh, okay. Fair enough. Alright. There we go. There's three transfers done. How much money have we still got? 108 million, we still got 108 million. Why am I being so sheepish? Sheepish. What else do I need? Have we got any more fullbacks coming through? Because I could really do with a full. I'm not buying Valencia. Pereira's only just joined a club. We haven't. There's no fullbacks on this game. Why is there no fucking fullbacks? What else do we need? So we've got Martial, he can come on the bench. We've got Rashford, he can go on the bench. We've got Sandro, he can go there. You can go there. Swap you two round. Have we got enough? We need another right back, actually, quite desperately. This Solano guy's not good enough. So, is Costa back yet? Costa's back as well. Oh, blimey, we're going to have... We're going to be absolutely fucking stacked, mate. Now what, we'll put Correa on the bench because he's 23, he's got a little bit of youth about him. Might try and get rid of Vitolo. But we do need a right back. I do think a right back is necessary. The only problem that I've got one from Toulouse on my shortlist, but I just don't think he's not quick. That's my issue. I need quickness as a fullback. Neither of these two are quick. They're both young, but they're not quick. So here we are, just before the first game in the Europa Super Cup. This is going to be our first team. As you can see, we have I've decided I'm going to start Martial on the left. Lamar's going to be over on the right. Other than that, it's the same team that we had at the start. In terms of youngsters, we've signed a few. Scherz is one of them. He's on the bench. Not much else has happened other than that. So we are now ready for our first game as Atletico Madrid manager here on our new FIFA 19. I was about to say 18 out of habit. Shit, I've got to stop doing that. FIFA 19 career mode. Can we get that first win and a first trophy? Which actually, now I think about it, would be the first proper trophy, not counting playoff finals, that I've won on this game. So this could be a moment. This could be a moment. They've still got the... Oh, they haven't even got like the TV... They haven't got the broadcast package for the Super Cup. What the fuck? EA, sort it out. Seriously. Even Pez could manage that. Just because it's the Super Cup doesn't mean you don't... You end up treating it like shit. Oh, never mind. Let's go. Have they only got the... I don't actually know if the advertising's Champions League advertising or not for the UEFA Super Cup, but still, they could at least have the fucking TV broadcasting package for it. Well, they've played that through, haven't they? Oh, that's cheeky. Oh dear. How long's that taking? 3 minutes. That's good. That's good. Quick free kick. That's very simple, isn't it? It's not exactly like they had to do a lot to work that out. Well, that old black kind of avoided the ball instead of saving it, which isn't helpful when you're a goalkeeper. Never mind, there's a long way to go. We can't give up yet. Oh, we've got an opening here. Come on, Griezmann, come on. Come on. Oh, and you've fucked it up. Best chance we've had so far. Can we get a goal from the corner? No, of course we can't. Come on, Diop. Oh, it's a save. Come on. Oh, what the... Why are you there? Why does a defender have to go and be there? Out of all the fucking places. Never mind, we're getting there. We're slowly but surely... breaking them down. They will wilt at some point. It's just inevitable. Will he play it in? Now it's with Saul. Carrying a genuine threat here. Oh, that's a good header. It's a decent save as well, to be fair. Real Madrid moving the ball with purpose. What can they do from this position? Oh, fuck off. Seriously, fuck off. Why? Second bloody shot. Do goalkeepers do anything? Do they do anything on this game, or do they just fall to the floor avoiding the ball? I'm not having that. Ugh. God fucking damn it, Argos. Yeah. I don't even know what I'm saying. How are you meant to know? The ball in. That's not who I really cut. Griezmann, shoot. What the fucking hell was that? I had problems with you in the demo, for fuck's sake. Are we going to have this all bloody series? I'm not going to be able to use one of the best players in the fucking European football. Well, I don't want to say bullshit, but I mean, oh, how the fuck is this happen? How the fuck does this happen? How does this happen? Does that happen to other people? Is it just me? I can't just be, can we? Come on, we've had enough chances to score at 5, so on the basis, if we do this again, oh, we can score here. Come on, come on. Oh, you've hit the... Oh. Oh, come on, Griezmann. Oh, why? Why? What is wrong with you? I'm both aiming that at him and me. Come on. Oh, he's hit the bar now. Jesus. I can't be bothered with this. I can't. Oh, don't go and counter. Oh, this is so infuriating. Oh, go away. Come on. Don't need a third. Oh, we've hit the post again. Oh, God's sake. What the Why have I liked this game series for so fucking long? It's treated me like shit for years. It's just a glorified preseason friendly anyway, am I right? It's just a shit Community Shield, isn't it, really? It's in the shadow of the Community Shield. Everyone prefers the Community Shield. Yep, cool. How the fuck has this happened? Honestly, how the fuck has this happened? How have we managed to lose this game 3-0? I don't want to say this is got to be one of my least deserved 3-0 defeats I've ever had. Got that. Yeah, I don't really need to see them lifting the trophy, do I? Do I have to see this? I mean, it looks lovely. I'm sure it'll go great in your trophy cabinet with your 14,000 fucking Champions League trophies. Fuck off. How have we lost this 3-0? How? How on earth has this happened? We've had 10 shots on target. Ugh. Well, that wraps up episode 1. The only positive is we don't have to play Real Madrid every fucking game, so might actually win some. Next episode will be the first league game. I think it's against Valencia. Hopefully it will go slightly better than that did, because let's face it, that went atrociously. But 3.5 million, nice. Oh. Yep, anyway, if you enjoyed that, leave a like. If there's anyone else I should sign, I've still got a shit ton of money, so if you feel like there's someone we should get, maybe a goalkeeper that doesn't fall over, but we got a 90 rated one, so supposedly they're the best, so it can only get worse if anything. But yeah, if there's anyone you think we should sign, leave them in the comments below. If you're new around here, be sure to subscribe. Yep, I'll see you in the next episode. Goodbye. Fucking hell, that went awfully.